All right, some sweet science. Let's go. Beautiful combination. Yes, keep it up. Put the pressure on her. All right, that was good. Definitely making some progress. Work, let's work. Keep working on that boxing damage. That's what I need. Great. Hey, great. Great boxing damage. Okay? Good job. Come on, 30. Today, let's go in there and get after it. That's it. Oh. Whoa, nice kick. Yep, she felt that one. Hey, good job today. You really crushed it out there. Come on, 30 seconds left. Good job in there. He kicks him. Fight anywhere, standing, against the cage, or on the ground. Let's get her down and control where the fight happens. Let's go. Listen, you keep training like that, and no one will catch you. That's it. Make it happen. Get heavy in there. Let's sag. Thirty seconds. Let's go. How's that? Feel good? We're really gonna tighten it up. Here we go. Okay, this is how we train to win the belt. Good combination work. Come on. That's it. Nice pass. Nice pass. That was pretty good. Yes, focus. Focus on locking it down. Thirty seconds. Good work. Maintain control. All right, let's push the pace on her. Nice! All right, let's see what you got today. Speed and power, that's it. Okay, okay, yep, I see you. That kick damaged you. Let's go, stay busy. Yeah, work on that kickboxing damage. Yes! Great! Let's do another. I want to see your skills right now. Let's get in there and push. Yes, that's what I'm talking about. Huge kick. That must hurt. Nice block. Block. got 30 seconds. Let's go. Good, good. Moving on now. Have a strong wrestling base. You can't fight without it. So let's get it. Yes, that's the way you master your craft. Focus, focus. She's got nothing against your takedowns. Here we go. There you go. Be ready. Let's get after it. Control that. Come on, 30 seconds left. Now do something with it. How was that? JJ, we are looking for your sparring partner to tap, okay? Not blackout, but tap out. So let's be playful. Let's go. Excellent job. There we go. That's the position we want. Let's go. There we go. There we go. Position before submission. I like it. Nice, nice, nice. Finish it now. Here we go. All right, let's push the pace on her. Seconds. Nice work. Lock her down. I know you can do better than that. You've got a lot.
Ain't no one to blame me when I'm gone. The measure of a man. Is where he makes a stand. I've stood here in the rough. It's gone on long enough. Ain't nobody's fault but my own.
ain't nobody's fault but my own. Ain't nobody else that I owe. Ain't no one say that I was wrong. Ain't no one to blame me.
Coming up next, a matchup for the UFC Women's Bantamweight Division title. All right, here's the number one women's bantamweight contender. She believes for a while she's been the best at 135 pounds. She's making the walk tonight, staring down the champion. Confidence, not an issue. Fear, not a factor. We'll see if this talented number one contender can shed that label and leave with a new one as the UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion. Changed hands quite a bit, but not since it's been held down by this young woman, the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion of the world. She has really set the standard for excellence at 135 pounds. Tonight, though, facing a number one contender that comes in with a lot of momentum. So if she can defend the belt yet again here tonight, it would really go a long way in stamping her legacy as one of the greatest bantamweight fighters and champions of all time. Our tale of the tape for this, our main event of the evening. More than 5 years apart, with some differences in height and a similar reach. Now for the introductions, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening.
When the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Yves Levine.
And now,
this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for.
Live from the sold-out Prudential Center in Newark, New Jersey, it's time! 5 rounds for the undisputed UFC Bantamweight Championship of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner.
This woman is a mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 15 wins, 8 losses.
She stands 5 feet 6 inches tall, weighing in at 135 pounds.
Presenting the challenger, Aspen Ladd.
And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner.
This woman is a kickboxer holding a professional record of 31 wins, no losses.
She stands 5 feet 3 inches tall,
weighing in at 131 pounds.
Fighting out of New York, New York,
presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion of the world.
UFC belt on the line. Protect yourself at all time. Obey my command at all time. If you want to touch love, do it now. Go back to your corner.
The fighters touch him up.
Ready?
All right. right, so round one is underway. After her last fight, you heard Bruce Buffer say, and still, UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion. She is trying to have him say it again here tonight. She is unquestionably the number one 135-pound fighter in the world. She has successfully defended this belt in the past, and she believes here tonight she's on a different level than the number one contender. We'll see if she can prove it here and turn those words into actions as round one gets underway. Left punch followed by a right. Nice 1-2 there by Torres. Stuffs the takedown shot there. How good is her takedown, D? Man, her striking looks clean tonight. Timing on point.
Her timing's on point. Her accuracy.
Oh!
You can never know what.
Oh! Back to the feet.
Nice kick. Right hand punch from the clinch.
Now goes in and secures the takedown. Working on a guillotine.
Watch guillotine.
Oh, we're getting a finish here. And this might just be a matter of time. And that will do it.
Wow. What a fight!
Yeah, no doubt about it. That is some opportunistic grappling right there. And nice finishing instincts as well. You see a lot of fighters get the dominant position, but aren't necessarily able to lock up the choke or force the tap. No problem with her as she gets one of the bigger wins of her UFC career. All right, let's check out some of the action in that previous round, DC. She certainly kept the stat trackers busy with all those takedowns.
All those takedowns and some really nice takedowns. She did a great job of level changing, getting into her opponent, not allowing her opponent to defend before she can secure her takedown.
So there she is as the celebration continues in the corner. The queen of the 135ers, the UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion, your winner tonight by way of submission. What a way to get the job done and leave with the UFC gold.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine's called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 28 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by tap out and still. Champion of the world, Torres!
The Bantamweight Queen retains her title here tonight in a huge effort to get the job done. The belts are piling up at home.
She did everything she intended to do in this fight. She knew where she held the advantages, and she stayed in her lane to retain her title.
I wonder if she would trade her new belt to you for one of the old ones.
She won a lot of the old ones. The old ones were better. I won. Why do you think I'm
don't
hanging around?
Don't say that. You'll have, by the time this game comes out,
Why am I holding on to
a new belt?
Yeah, I want the new
belt. Just get one.
Just one.
This round, I just want to see heavy punches. Let it go. Good, good work with the hands. Yes, I love it. She's starting to fall apart, right? Okay, let's go. Listen, you keep training like that, and no one will catch you. Nice punch. Yeah, nice punch. She felt that one. Yes, devastating punch. Great job. And 30 to go. Let's go! That's what I like to see. Good, clean, crisp punches. Today, I want to see you sharp and quick. Beautiful combination. Uh-huh, keep it up. Put the pressure on her. Put the pressure on her. Let's go. Good work. Next set. Speed on that combo. More of that. Let's go. You got 30 seconds. Let's go. Don't worry about today. Tomorrow is gonna be a lot better. For the takedown. Once you get on top, control her. Use your weight and pin her to the mat. Circle, circle, circle. Come on, go, go, go!
Good, yes. I love those strikes. Nice combination there. Let's go. Awesome job. Let's move on. Don't stop now. 30 on the clock. Yes! Let's keep that up. All right. Great job. But I need... Fast, smooth, strong. That's what we're doing today. That's how we work. This is when we put it all together. Great job. Nice! Nice work in there. Now work on the finish. Nice, nice. You're almost there. The tap is coming. Nice pass. Keep working. Got 20 seconds. Saw some nice work today that led to some great... All right, some sweet science. Let's go. Beautiful combination. Yes, keep it up. Put the pressure on her. Yeah, that'll leave a bruise. That's it. Come on. That's it. Just like that. Listen, you keep training like that, and no one will catch you. 30 seconds. Let's go. That's it. Here we go. You're right. Let's get in there. Let's push yourself today. Let's see what you got. All right. That was good. Definitely making some progress. Beautiful combination. Uh-huh. Keep it up. Put the pressure on her. Put the pressure on her. Let's go. Yeah, yeah, more of that. I like it. Big kicks. Come on, go, go, go! Ready to go. Show me. Your kicks are on point. Anytime. Smoking cushy with my dogs. The way she made it, you got it looking like applause. I'm getting all these plaques and got enough space on my bar. Diamonds dripping like a faucet. Big bag, I want a big bag. If it ain't getting money, you can skip that. Big bag, I want a big bag. Put you in a two-seater, let you kick back. I'm still whiz, got me in that mood. How they hating when they know that I'm that dude? I hear they hating cause they know I got the juice. Uh-huh, they like, ooh. They watching how I move. They be acting like we cool. This was, I ain't no fool. Still keep it real, still park the whip and chill, still never popping pills, still got them in they feels, still give them chills, pill, $100 bills, had a crib in the hills, one trip, couple mil, hot, fall asleep and still making sales, one hand on the wheel, couple bands on the meal, playing on the field, wet on the scale, in the air for 20 years, I was unavailable, seen how much I'm worth, started thinking I was dateable, all my getting rich, dudes, I done paid a few. Smoking weed by the zip, millions, I done made a few. Stick to stamp, stacking up. Way big bag, I want a big bag. If it ain't getting money, you can skip that. Big bag. Means you dictate where the fight goes. It can stay on the feet, or in a second, get taken to the ground. That's the power of wrestling. More of that. Push! 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 Pinpoint. Seconds. Let's get after it. All right, you had a little trouble today, but don't worry about it. We're gonna get better.
All right, coming up next, it is our main event, a matchup for the UFC Women's Bantamweight title. Well, this is a belt that has changed hands quite a bit, and this number one bantamweight contender believes it will again here tonight as she makes the walk for this title fight. She believes this title shot should have come earlier. She's not caught up in all that now, hasn't been during fight week. She's focused on the champion, and you see her staring her down right now. Crowd going crazy. She believes she is the best bantamweight in the world and believes in a matter of moments here, she will be the new champion. Quite a bit, but not since it's been held down by this young woman, the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion of the world. She has really set the standard for excellence at 135 pounds. Tonight, though, facing a number one contender that comes in with a lot of momentum. So if she can defend the belt yet again here tonight, it would really go a long way in stamping her legacy as one of the greatest bantamweight fighters and champions of all time. Our tale of the tape for this women's bantamweight championship fight. More than a decade separates these two fighters when it comes to the age. Some differences in height and reach as well. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Eve Loving. This is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas, it's time! Five rounds for the undisputed UFC Bantamweight Championship of the World. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This woman is a wrestler holding a professional record of 21 wins, 6 losses. She stands 5 feet 8 inches tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of Manaus, Arizona, Brazil, presenting the challenger, Caitlin Venomino Vieira. And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This woman is a kickboxer holding a professional record of 32 wins, no losses. She stands 5 feet 3 inches tall, weighing in at 131 pounds. Fighting out of New York, New York, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion of the World.
If you want to like, thank yourself at all time. We'll be my command at all time. If you want to touch love, do it now. Go back to your corner.
They touch him up, and we are underway. So here we go with round one of this UFC Women's Bantamweight Championship fight. This is the fight that fans really wanted to see. The consensus top two 135ers in the world. The champion doesn't necessarily see it that way. She believes she is a level up. She has defended the title in the past. That is a great source of confidence for her as she tries to remain the hunted here at 135 pounds. All right, first round is underway. Many people expected a big storyline in this one.
Oh! Can't get picked now. She has to react. She has to go chase the finish.
Well, she did not miss a single grappling practice during this training camp, and here's your evidence. Outstanding movement on the ground.
She looks like a master of grappling with the great movement that she's showing on the ground.
job by her there. You see how strong she is. Her opponent's trying to control posture, unable to do so.
Now she can get to work and put the money in the bank with that grounding pound.
Money in the bank. Torres is back in full mount. Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
All right, she postures up here, DC. We'll see if she can get those ground strikes going.
Watch for the huge elbows that she's known for.
Oh, when you get in a bad spot on the ground and you want to reverse it, that's what you need to do.
Masterclass in changing position, unreal to see.
All right, so her ground control is outstanding. Half guard is when she's at her most dangerous.
Yeah, she's at her most dangerous when she has a half guard because she's so brutal with the grounded pound. She likes to go after fighters and really wear on them, force them to make decisions to give their backs so that she can chase her submissions, or they're gonna lay on their back and just get beaten up from the top from that beautiful half guard position. Oh,
nice. Nicely done. Strong bottom work here, staying busy. 45 seconds to go here in round one. Great movement by her here on the ground, and she just does it so fluidly and so easily. It's really a sight to behold.
You can tell that she's been a lifetime developing the skill with the way that she's able to move with so little effort on the mat.
Torres' pass is denied. Oh, how about that reversal by her there, champ?
That is a fantastic transition by this young lady. What a job.
All right, so she's making her way back to the stool, kind of shaking her head, thought maybe that knockdown would have produced a finish. Not so much.
She's a little discouraged right now because she thought the fight was over. But if you know her, if you spent any time with her, you understand that she's a smart fighter, and she will get right back to doing what she needs to do to win this fight.
All right, second round underway.
What a punch.
Oh, that's a pretty filthy combination.
Oh, hurt, yep.
Well, back to her feet, and potentially a critical takedown here. Oh, that's a nice job by her there to reverse the position on the ground.
She was in trouble. Now she is the one handing out the punishment. Great change of position very quickly.
Torres is back in half guard. Oh, that's a beautiful escape and reversal by her there.
Unbelievable sweep. She did a fan.
Looks like she's trying to set up a sub here.
Oh!
Oh, we're getting a finish here. And this might just be a matter of time. Submission defense there. All right, side control for her now. And you know how heavy she stays with all of that upper body strength. We'll see what she can do from here. Might be able to hook onto an arm here. Nicely done. Wow, there is just a viciousness with which she operates here on the ground as she continues to get the ground and pound game going. She might get a finish here.
She's looking for a finish. She's so good at dictating these ground exchanges, and she's doing a fantastic job of building posture to try to land that kill shot from the top.
half guard position for her here. And if you're the bottom fighter, this is truly a case of pick your poison.
Yeah, you got to pick your poison. And if you're on the bottom, you got to be trying to find a way to escape that bottom leg. You cannot allow your opponent, you cannot allow her to sit on your leg and just throw big damage and strikes. You got to make sure you're on an elbow control and underhook and getting back to your feet.
All right, half guard position for her here, and this is a spot where we've seen her have a lot of wild success in previous fights.
She has a tremendous amount of success with this position because she's so knowledgeable. She keeps the right side underhook, and she just goes to work with that left arm. She's posting and elbowing. She's building her posture and punching. There are just so many different ways for her to score strikes from this position.
Oh, going for the arm bar now. That might be tight. Nicely done. And that's the end of round number two. All right, so we will see another round here. Sat her opponent down there in that previous round with a punch.
Surprisingly, we are going forward because I thought it was over. I saw that punch land. We started to yell. We started to scream. We thought the fight was done, but we moved forward because her opponent is so tough, but she's so skilled that she can get there again.
All right, here we go with this third round of this championship fight. Oh, really using her reach advantage there with that punch, DC. Vieira gets caught with that punch. Oh, pretty good series of punches by her there. She certainly has found the range early tonight.
She can box with anybody in the world, and she's showing that tonight. If your opponent has you in the clinch, pulling down on your head, landing punch after punch, you have got to clear that collar tie, reach back inside and try to find space.
Oh, an instinctive land there as she goes to the jab, DC. Nicely done.
That jab. Oh! You can never know what you're gonna see with this shot.
Do you believe it? That was a good stoppage by the referee. She was not effectively defending herself, and the opponent was doing some real damage. It became a dangerous situation. I think it's the right call by the official, and she will live to fight another day. All right, we take a look back at some of the pictures from this one, and she had it all going on tonight, but certainly her boxing was on point.
Her boxing always is what allows her to dictate the pace of fights. Finally, she landed the strike that ended the night of her opponent.
Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve LeVig has called a stop to this contest at 1:10 of the third round, declaring the winner by knockout and still the undisputed UFC Bantamweight Champion of the World, Torres.
Well, not unlike the great Israel Adesanya, she doesn't hope and pray. She aims and fires, and she is still the UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion.
What a great champion that rules atop his division. She's the queen of the world, in one of the UFC's best women's division.
her touch, brown and white. I got good country, grab and buy. We can go bust, eye for eye. We can lose trust, white rum, fizzy pop. Where you they go, go, we they go up. Catch my vibe, let me go off. Blam the trice, man it's so tough.
Alright yo, put the belly on the body, make a clutch. See no watch, now she wanna give. Boy got peas, now she hopping in the pod. Man a real life sugar gal, I might forget what. When she want dark, told her meet me at the top. Switching lanes the other day, I seen her waiting for a bus. Maybe just a Moncler sweater, diesel denim. Buy another one, my pockets fat like heather. Neck froze like I don't know no better. Benzo truck, white seats and they leather. Go broke never, on my grind. She make it clap like I'm Busta Rhymes. I got the juice, the sauce and all them things. I blammed her twice a night with all my bling. Big Benz, I drive, I brought that thing. Any girl you want, they want my ting.
Don't rush, slow touch, brown and white. Like I go country, grab and buy. We can go bust, eye for eye. We can lose trust, white rum, fizzy pop. Where you they go, go, we they go up. Catch my vibe, let me go off. Blam the trice, man it's so tough.